Hello, Bobcats, and welcome back to another school year.
And welcome back to another episode of The Sage. I'm Christopher Kathman, the new broadcast editor-in-chief.
And I'm Chisholm Hoffman, the web editor-in-chief for this year.
We're so excited to cover all things Sage Creek this 2019-2020 school year.
So let's get right into it.
With back to school comes back to school dances.
That's right. Sage Creek always finds a way to hold the best dances right at the start of the school year.
Malia Williams and I got the opportunity to cover Sage Cella this year. Let's take a look at last Friday's party. On Friday the 13th of this month, ASB hosted its very first school dance 3 weeks into the school year. Accompanied by trays of food, lots of glitter, henna tattoos, and the usual sweaty teen bodies jumping up and down to the sound of Miley Cyrus, this dance set the bar pretty high for future Sage Creek Ragers. With all the fun activities and loud music, it was hard to tell what everyone's favorite part was. Luckily, we were able to pull out a few Sage Creek party animals for their take on Sage Cella.
My favorite part? Definitely my friends and hanging out, and also I love the glitter, like outside, it's so much fun.
The music is so much better than it was a while ago, it's great.
Dude, the dance is a blast right now, there's tons of energy, the music is dank. The people are having a great time.
Absolutely spectacular. It's really fun. I feel like it's more fun if you make it fun, get a circle, have fun with your friends. If you're just standing there not doing anything, it's not gonna be fun. So you just gotta make what you make it.
Us Sage Creek Ravers can't wait to see what ASB pulls together for their next dance. This has been Christopher Kathman and Malia Williams. Now back to the anchors.
Great job, Chris and Malia. Seems like Sage Cella was quite the fun time.
It was. However, it was not so fun coming back to school on Monday, Chromebook in hand.
Ah, yes, the Chromebooks. We love them until half of the keys are gone.
Very true. I wonder what everyone thinks about this new take-home plan with the Chromebooks this year.
I was actually wondering the same thing about 2 weeks ago, so I went ahead and interviewed some staff and students on their thoughts about this new process.
This school year, you may see less Chromebook carts wheeling around school and more students carrying them in their backpacks. Last year, the freshman class was able to utilize this personalized computer ratio, and now that opportunity has been opened up to all Sage Creek students. And Ms. Player is the staff member that oversees this new process.
So specifically, if you have trouble with your Chromebook, please come see me. I'm right here in the library, and I'll help you out. So think of your Chromebook like a device you carry around with you like your phone. Bring it to school charged every day, and you're going to do great.
Coming from 3 years of previously having Chromebook carts in his classroom, senior Nathan Pereira has seen firsthand the effects of this new process.
In school, it is a little convenient because I can just pull it out whenever I want to, and I don't need to like see if the Chromebook cart is unlocked. It does its job in giving everybody a device to use. For me personally, I only use it in school. I never use it outside of school, and so essentially, it would be the same thing as having a Chromebook cart, but I mean, it makes it easier on the teachers.
Students who perhaps didn't have a device at home to do schoolwork now have one. So just the fact that they have that device to bring home so that they have equal access to all the digital resources that we use in each class, I think is a huge benefit. Sort of levels the playing field slightly, as well as now they have to take ownership over their device. It's no longer something that the teacher is responsible for. They don't get to keep it in the classroom. Now they have to learn how to take care of their device, remember to plug it in. It just is practicing more responsibility.
Though already so efficient in the STEM field, Sage Creek is always continuing to make big strides and becoming more and more technologically efficient. And with this new Chromebook process, students get to practice firsthand technological responsibility. This has been Tristan Hoffman reporting for The Sage. Now back to the anchors.
I think it's such a great opportunity to have a computer at home now for those who didn't before.
I completely agree. However, my back does sometimes hurt a little carrying it around all the time, but pain is gain.
I think our Sage Creek athletes can agree with the last statement.
Let's kick it over to our Sage Creek sports editors, Paige Zepeda and Harper Hughes, for a quick but exciting sports promo for fall sports.
Well, that's all we got for you this week, Bobcats.
Make sure to head over to thesagenews.com for all the news stories coming this year.
And make sure to follow at The Sage Publication on Instagram and Twitter. Thanks so much for watching. This has been Christopher Kathman
and Tristan Hoffman reporting for
The Sage.